I mean, I could have been a lawyer. Okay, maybe a teacher. Instead, I'm an actor. Mostly, I'm a fool for hire. I wait tables. I do focus groups. I scooped ice cream. I make tequila shots. I pour hot coffee. I carry hot plates with my bare hands. And today, today, I'm letting a woman named Smokey put this itchy makeup on my face in front of other people who want to learn how to do it. I'm a bride today. It's a bridal makeup workshop. And I have been here since 8:30 in the morning. And it's getting on to be about 1 p.m. Sitting, waiting in the salon with the other two girls. Two blondies and me. We are each getting paid $350 to do this, so there isn't much complaining about the waiting. After all, we're actresses. We are used to the waiting. Kirsten is reading a book about deadly Mormons and religious cults, and Cheryl's on the phone, planning her weekly calendar of a zillion jobs. And me, I am reading the Dalai Lama's An Open Heart, trying to become a less angry Buddhist. We wait. My turn. She calls me into the studio. I catch a glimpse of the students. They're all older than I had imagined. And drab. They look like haggard housewives from Staten Island, not young, creative makeup artists. I sit stiffly on the stool next to Smokey, a big, black, voluptuous woman who seems nice enough. Although Smokey was a little confused earlier by the shape of my eyebrows when she was prepping my face, she asked me if I had them plucked, you know, styled, waxed or anything. I told her, not really. She said if I were a bride coming to her for a consultation, she would tell me to have them styled. Definitely, have them styled. I have unusual eyebrows. I mean, well, compared to everyone else. In my family, we call them brushstroke eyebrows. They tend to slope down and then up again at the last moment, like a paintbrush creating a Japanese character. My grandmother, as does my father, as do I, all have a little sadness in our faces. My mother used to tell me growing up, "Don't let anyone mess with your eyebrows, young lady. They are very special." Growing up as a child actor, people were always putting makeup on me, you know, evening out my freckles with concealer, rouging my eyelids to make them look bigger, hairspraying my eyebrows to make them stick up, pulling at my eyelashes to make them curl. I didn't think about it too much. I was just a kid then, other than it was uncomfortable. Now here I am again, in the chair. Except I'm 26 now, and there are 9 students looking at my face. None of them are Asian. In fact, no one here is Asian. I noticed that right away. I try to relax a little. After all, it's an all too familiar feeling. Smokey begins the class. "Now, we're going to do a little something different on Kiera here." I smile at the word different. A squinty, mid-40-ish woman raises her hand. "Yeah, excuse me, excuse me. Yeah, what color are we going to do the crease?" My heart stops. The crease? The eye fold? The part of a non-Asian person's eye that folds back below the brow bone? The crease? There was an awkward moment. And suddenly the word round eye pops into my head and I want to blurt out, "Wow! Your eyes are so big! They're so round! You gotta catch a fly with your big eyes!" Smokey leans in. "What is your heritage, honey?" "Japanese half," I tell her. People rarely ask about the other half, so I rarely tell them. "So it would be correct to say you were of Asian descent, right?" "Yes." "Yes," I smile tightly. "Yes." Relieved she didn't say Oriental. Nervous that this discussion was getting uncomfortable. Me, half-breed, Smokey, black, and the other out-of-touch Caucasian students from Long Island or Staten Island, where the fuck these round eyes lived. "Well, traditionally, Asian people..." don't have a crease. They just don't have one. Students were very confused by this. I mean, their little minds are being tied up in knots. What was this creaseless world their fearless leader Smokey was speaking of? I mean, their little makeup parades were being rained on, and their mascara wasn't even waterproof. And then Smokey chimes in, bringing the sunshine to the clouds that they had been awaiting. However, we can give Kiri here the illusion of a crease. Suddenly an image of Connie Chung pops into my head. Oh, God! And I hear an audible sound of relief. My ears are hot, and I try to hold back the salty water from mixing with my concealer as Smokey smooths the soft brush over my eyelids, creating the illusion of something I was born without. Something my white as Wonder Bread mama didn't pass on. I look at Smokey, and she seems to apologize to me with her smile, complimenting me through the rest of the class. Now, you see how high her cheekbones are? We don't want to use too much blush on Kiara here because she has got some very nice features, doesn't she, class? They all nod. The crease question raises her hand again. Yeah, Smokey? Yeah. You want to go any darker? You want to go any darker with that crease? No. Smokey simply but sternly states and proceeds to my lips, which appear to be just fine the way they are. I drift far away to my grandmother's makeup table, and I wonder how she felt. Did she see something missing? Or was she pleased when staring at her reflection, she remembered her mother's mournful eyebrows and smooth eyelids? I look at the class. I look at Smokey and I think, why not just leave me the way I am?
It's fine how you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn.